Hi everyone, Sandman here. This video is brought to you by a donation by someone named Umit, and he says it was just because with no topic. So that allows me to cover an article I recently came across up here in Canada called Why Are Good Men So Hard to Find? It's another one of those opinion pieces that attempts to shame the non-existent male readership of modern newspapers. The average reader of newspapers is in their late 40s or early 50s, or even older, so all those Where Have All the Good Men Gone articles are pretty much falling on deaf ears, or no ears whatsoever. The article says that women in their mid-30s are suffering because of a lack of eligible and responsible guys out there. But none of the blame is being put on women because they themselves are old and all the good men are already gone. After women get to a certain age, that's usually when their good options start to dry up, along with their breast milk. The author of this piece, an older woman named Margaret Wente, says that older women should be grateful that they aren't one of today's early to mid-30s single women. Margaret says that the online dating market has made things easier for men. Here's a brief paragraph from that article, so you know exactly where I'm coming from, and I quote, "Single women are more equal and empowered than ever before. They have unparalleled sexual, reproductive, and economic autonomy. In many ways, they're doing much better than men. Just look at the lopsided university graduation rates, which are now 60 to 40 in favor of women. And yet large numbers of women admit their private lives are a sad mess. If you're a gender studies major, stop reading here. You're going to hate what I've actually got to say next. I didn't like it much myself. In a nutshell, over the past few decades, the traditional relationship exchange has broken down. It used to be that men and women each had something that the other really needed. Men needed access to sex, women needed access to resources. Men couldn't get steady access to sex unless they had resources to offer, so they worked hard for them. The partnership between men and women was a grand bargain that usually left both sides better off. For men, sex was traditionally expensive. The price tag was a long-term commitment to provide for a woman and children. But today, sex is cheap, and that changes everything." Unquote. So after reading that, gents, whose fault is this situation? Women don't actually have to give up sex if they don't want to. If they want men to commit, then women en masse need to keep sex scarce, but they have a hard time doing that. At the same time, on the other side of the aisle, men complain that women actually have all the reproductive cards. They can choose to be on the pill, get an abortion, keep the baby, or put it up for adoption. Men have none of these options, yet men are being shamed and told, well, if you don't want her to have a baby, keep it in your pants. Just like now I'm saying to all the ladies listening to this, if you want a man to stick around, don't let them stick it in too quick. But you won't actually do that because the sooner you get him in the sack, the sooner he falls in love, and the sooner you can start controlling him. You'd think that this author Margaret is just like all the other female authors out there trying to shame men. But the statements I read earlier aren't for Margaret. Those ideas actually belong to the American sociologist Mark Regeneres. He says that sex and intimacy got cheap because of technological developments. Well, Mark, welcome to 2012, you're only about 5 years behind the times. He says that sexual liberation is great, but it can turn men into lazy louts. Because of course we can't possibly say that sexual liberation can turn women into sluts now, can we? It can only turn men into louts. It's all men's fault once again. We must shame all men into working harder to be the catch that 30-something women deserve. Mark says that today's dating market is dominated by men's interests over women's. This mangina seems to have no idea that women hold all the cards. It sounds to me that the real reason he's saying all of this is because women make the majority of the book purchases these days, and he's just pandering to his audience. He mirrors what women have to say by saying that men that are sober, steady, and good providers are hard to find these days. He says that men can pretty much get all the sex they want on demand. With that point, I will agree with him to some extent. I too could go on Tinder today and within a week or so be on some dates and getting laid. Now that I know that sex isn't scarce, I don't pursue it as much as I once did. Plus, I prefer getting intimate in front of the computer, if you know what I mean. Mark needs to look into loverbots and AR technology because, soon enough, men won't need access to women at all. We will have resources and instant physical gratification, and we simply won't need women anymore. Women will always need men because it's their biological imperative to seek out protection and provision, and also companionship, regardless of if they can provide it for themselves or not. They're like the convenience store clerk seeking out protection from the local mafia. They're like a moth drawn to a flame. They need men no matter how much they actually don't want to admit it. Their survival instinct to be around men kicks in because in nature, a woman without a man would pretty much perish. So as men go their own way in greater numbers, it's only going to get worse for women. Not only will they actually make a living as wage slaves, but they'll also hate being alone because every single fiber in their being is telling them subconsciously that death is near because there aren't any men around. Good men are hard to find these days because society doesn't reward good men. Instead, it punishes them by taking away their income and families. why be a good man and have society lose respect for you when you can be allowed and enjoy yourself as things pretty much crumble all around you? Why would any sane man get together with a woman that's more successful than him to get nagged, yelled at, and be made to feel inferior? Instead, all the good men aren't being made anymore, and the few good ones still around are staying off the market and living for themselves. I'm on track to be able to retire by 50. Why would I want to share that with a woman that brings hardly anything to the table? Why would I want to sift through piles of bad women to maybe find one mediocre one? Margaret, the author of this article, also says that traditionally, both sides are better off under the old arrangement. But that was never the case. The woman was the one that was always better off. She got the whole house minus the garage, where the guy would pretty much keep his tools to repair the rest of the house. He gets a glorified janitor's closet and she gets the rest. The article attempts to make traditionalism appear good to men because we once upon a time got love and sex out of it. I'm predicting that this isn't the last of the Where Have All the Good Men articles gone. Many of the women writing such articles ignore the slutty nature of women and instead bring out the shame against men. It's always men's fault. They never stop and think that at some point there will be diminishing returns to shaming language, that this isn't going to work anymore. To explain this idea further, I've actually put a classic Karen Strawn video in the description called Men Not Marrying. How deep does the problem go? She sums it up perfectly. Why would men want to get married when there isn't any respect in it for them or self-worth? Women are human beings and men are human doings. Women have value just for existing because of their womb, while men actually have to earn value and respect. Our society makes it impossible for men to earn respect, so men say, why bother? Why should we actually care about doing things for others and sacrificing when all we get is shame and foul language thrown back at us? Obviously, they want our resources, but they aren't even willing to trade respect for them. All they know how to do is lay the shame on thicker when we don't produce. They're pretty much doubling down on shame. We are doubling down on going our own way. I first became aware of this Canadian article through MGTOW.com. I put a link to that forum in the description as well. It's the third one down below. One man on that forum has this to say, and I quote, I think I was a good man once. I gave away my time, my money, my heart, my soul, and my blood to keep my marriage going. Somehow having everything I was or ever would be was just not enough. She sucked me dry like a juice pouch and then threw me away. So now I have no time that I'm willing to give to a woman, no money to spare, my heart is cold and black, my soul is my own, and my blood is my own. I have nothing left to give. I would be a horrible choice for a woman, unquote. I think that pretty much sums up how I feel as well as many other guys out there. Our hearts have turned cold and black because we were told once upon a time that women were kind and good, and when we learned that wasn't necessarily the case, we walked away permanently in some cases. The numbers of under 20 and early 20-something MGTOWs continue to swell. Men aren't buying it anymore. Even sex is no longer enough when her attitude is that of a fire-breathing dragon covered in tattoos with purple hair. Another person on that forum says that the ladies want men to roll out the red carpet for damaged goods. A few days ago, I was hanging out with a buddy of mine, and my brother showed up and shamed him by asking, "When are you getting married?" He got pissed off and told my brother, why would he want to ruin his life by getting tied down to someone? My brother believes that his marriage means other men respect him. What he doesn't realize is that men are losing respect for married men and starting to see them as buffoons. My brother still hasn't processed this, and for his sake, I hope he doesn't. Because if he ever does, the red pill rage will be like an atomic bomb going off. Another person on MGTOW.com says that men are being stereotyped as lazy louts, incompetent, stupid, unreliable, deadbeats, and other derogatory words. Men are being told we are scum and told to man up, and when we do man up, we're being punished for it. The only course of action, of course, is no action. Go MGTOW. But even then, we're called lazy. The article closes with this line, and I quote, good husband material doesn't occur naturally, but is instead the product and part of socialization, development, and social control, unquote. In other words, according to Winterhand on MGTOW.com, he says that, so a normal man can't be good marriage material until women have molded, controlled, and beaten him into submission. If that's what it takes to be a good man and get married, then the whole marriage thing can burn. As men, all of our male spaces have been systematically destroyed or taken down in real life. All we really have left is the internet, and we're now going to fight for our male spaces here because it's all we have left. Women will keep coming in and shaming us and putting us in our place and keep testing us. We will keep passing their online tests because we won't give up and surrender what we have. The bigger the MGTOW grows, the bigger the problem women will have finding men to provide and protect for them. They are hardwired to seek out male protection and provision the way that men are programmed to seek out love and intimacy. As men, we could admit our needs and urges. Women, on the other hand, deny they actually have the urge to find a good man and be with him. They say they don't need a man so they can appear to be strong when they're actually weak. The fish needing a bicycle thing is just their pathetic attempt to say, we don't need a man. But then they keep asking about, where have all the good men gone? And are now trying to shame men into becoming the good men that they're looking for. Men are giving up en masse because we can't get any respect from women in society by manning up and getting married. According to Karen Strawn, if you get married and become a so-called good man, your reward is looking in the mirror and seeing Dilbert or Homer Simpson looking back at you. What kind of a reward is that? It's more like a punishment. I'd rather look in the mirror and see my own reflection, and if society and women don't respect me, at least I'll be able to respect and love myself. That's the consolation prize, and it's better than no prize at all. My mother would be classified as a good woman, and I see the way she treats my father. She acts like she doesn't respect him, and that's not the future that I want for myself. Any good man wouldn't actually want that for his future either. I recently got back from South Dakota, and I no longer think that traveling on my own is weird anymore. Halfway through my trip, one couple from Chicago were absolutely shocked that I was traveling on my own. The guy even asked me if I travel alone, and I said yes, and it didn't even feel weird. Anyways, that's all I've got to say for today. Thanks again, Umet, for your donation, and I hope you enjoyed this topic. Don't forget to smash the like button like women want to smash the MGTOW philosophy. Bang the bell and check out the MGTOW mystery link. Follow me on Twitter or like me on Facebook to get tomorrow's video today. Subscribe to me on Minds.com or Gab.ai to get the video for the day after tomorrow. Thanks for taking your daily dose of red pills, and remember, a red pill a day keeps the where of all the good men shaming tactics away. So enjoy the rest of your day, and cheers.